Hey everyone and welcome back. In the last video, I showed you how to create an action that allows you to create an effect on one photo and then easily apply it to your other photos without having to redo the effect from scratch on all of your photos. In this video, we're going to take a look at another use of actions and how they can be used to apply watermarks to your photos. Many photographers, to better protect their images, want to add a simple line of text somewhere on their photos, but the process can be very tedious. I'm going to start by showing you how you can create the action, and then I'm going to show you how you can use that action to apply your watermark to a large group of photos. To make your life easy, make sure that the image layer is selected in your layers panel. Now, just like we went over in the last video, pressing the new action button at the bottom of the actions panel will allow us to name the action and then start recording. As this watermark will be made using text, let's grab our type tool from the tools bar, and then using a nice sized font, type out your word of choice anywhere in your document. At this point, it doesn't matter where in your document it's created. I'm going to type out my name for this example. With my name typed out, I'm going to accept the type by hitting the check mark on the options bar, or I can use the command return shortcut on the Mac or control enter shortcut on Windows. Now we need to decide where we're going to place it. The bottom left hand corner of the image seems like a nice location, but of course you're free to place it wherever you please. Now, it's not as simple as dragging it into place, mainly because if you're working with different sized photos, or you initially created your text at a different location on your document, the end placement will always be different. To solve this, we're going to be working with the Move Tool's alignment options. First, we need to select the image layer along with our text. This is also not as simple as just selecting the image layer in the Layers panel. If we were to select the image layer here, the action would record that we selected layer 2. If on another document the image layer is layer 1, or the background layer, the action will fail. This is what we need to do. With the text layer still active, on the Mac hold down Option and Shift, and then press the left square bracket key. On Windows it'll be Alt, Shift, and the left square bracket key. As you can see in the Actions panel, instead of selecting layer 2, Photoshop recorded that step as Select Backward Layer, which in English means selected the layer directly behind the text, which is exactly what we want. With that done, grab your Move tool or shortcut V and direct your attention towards the options bar. The first 6 options are going to help us align the text based on the bounds of our image. As I want the text in the bottom left-hand corner, I'll start with the Align Bottom Edges button, which will align the text to the bottom edge of our image, and then use the Align Left Edges button to finish it off. Depending on the location you want in your watermark, you can also use the Align Top and the Align Right Edges option if needed. The advantage of using the alignment options is that no matter the size of your image, your text will always end up in the corner you desire. And of course, if you want to move your text slightly inwards, make sure only the text layer is selected, and then holding down your Shift key, pressing your arrow keys will move the text and record those steps in your action. Now we could end the action here, but just to show you what else can be added in an action, let me double click on the text layer to bring up our layer styles, and I'm going to add a simple drop shadow to my text. And then I'm going to hop back over to my blending options and decrease the opacity a touch. Perfect, let's end the action here. So now that our watermark action is complete, let's hop over to another image and make sure the background layer is selected. Now click on your new watermark action and with a simple click of the play button, the watermark is placed. Again, by using Photoshop's alignment options, our watermark will always land in the same place. So that's fine and dandy for images that are open in Photoshop, but what if you're looking to apply your new watermark to a whole group of images? Surely you don't want to open each and every image to apply your watermark. There has to be an easier way. Well, there is. Let me show you the magic of batch processes. Under your File menu, head down to Automate and then choose the Batch option. Once the Batch option appears, it's time to set up what's going to take place during the process. The first section deals with the action itself. Under the Action dropdown, find your newly created watermark action. The next section deals with the source files. In this case, we'll be using a folder that contains the images we want watermarked. So clicking on the Choose button, we can browse our system for that folder. This folder contains a few photos from a recent trip to the zoo. With the folder selected, we now have a few options in terms of saving. Leaving the destination at none will simply open the photo and apply the action and leave it for you to edit. Choosing Save and Close will execute the Save command after the watermark has been applied. The last option is Folder. This will allow us to set up conditions for your files and save them into a chosen folder. I'm going to choose the same folder as the source. Now for the file name, we can choose to keep the original file name by selecting document name, and then adding a number at the end of it by selecting one of the digit options on the right. Now it's good to note that unless you incorporated a save into your action, you will have to manually confirm each file as it's being saved. You'll see that in a moment. Otherwise, if you did add a save step command in your action, choosing the override action save as commands will skip the saving portion of your batch process and stick with what you recorded in your action. Alright, let's press OK and start the batch. Again, unless you recorded a save step in your action, you will be asked to confirm each image as it's saved, but it's still a lot faster than manually applying your watermark to each and every photo. So now that the batch process is finished, let's go ahead and check the folder where our images are contained. And as you can see in this folder, we have a group of images with no watermark and our new group of images with our new created watermark. So for photographers who deal with hundreds and hundreds of images, creating a watermark action may save you a lot of time. In the next video, I'm going to show you a brand new feature in Photoshop CS6 that allows you to record your tools in Photoshop.